after the first divorce, can I take back my wife or can we get remarried if the idda is over? You all know that the idda is the waiting period where the marriage is actually suspended. But after the first and the second marriage, the husband has the right to take his wife, whom he just divorced, back to his marriage life, even without her consent, because she's officially still his wife. If she die, if he dies in this condition, she will inherit from him. Here is a point. You know that Surah At-Talaq, there is a whole chapter in the Quran called At-Talaq. In the 28th para. Very beautiful. It talks about that. لَا تُخْرِجُوهُنَّ مِنْ بُيُوتِهِنَّ وَلَا يَخْرُجْنَ إِلَّا أَنْ يَأْتِينَ بِفَاحِشَةٍ مُبَيِّنَةٍ. That whenever you divorce your wife, you're not allowed simply to kick her out and say, okay, get out. It's your house. You paid for it. It's your own. But she is still in the idda. She must stay in the same house. I divorced her. Yes, I know. وَلَا يَخْرُجْنَ. What if she desires to leave? No, you're not allowed to leave as well. Why? Because of increasing the possibility of reconciling. Okay? So this is very important. That is the purpose of the idda. But when there was no reconciliation whatsoever until the idda is over, خلاص. Divorce has become final. Final in a sense that if they met again and for the sake of the children or they recognize their errors and they want to reconcile, okay, start all over from the scratch with a new marriage contract. With a new marriage contract. And we'll start counting the number of talaq from the very beginning. But if it was the third divorce, you can't do that. It's over. First, if it was the third divorce, you can't do that. First and second, you're allowed after the idda is over to reconcile if you want to, but it will require a new marriage contract, a new dowry, a new agreement, and new witnesses, and the consent of the wali as well.